Good morning all. Last class we studied London equations, and in this class we study flux quantization in superconducting ring. In Meissner effect, we know that when a superconductor is cold below transition temperature, the magnetic field lines will be expelled out of the superconducting material. Consider a superconductor. The superconductor is kept above the transition temperature, so the field lines can pass through the superconductor. This material is superconductor, it is a solid superconducting material, and it is kept at a temperature greater than TC. That means it is in normal conducting state, field lines can pass through the material. Now the same material is cooled below transition temperature, then the field lines will be expelled out of the superconducting material. No field line can pass through the superconducting material. So inside the superconductor, magnetic field intensity B is equal to zero. That is called Meissner effect. It is discovered by Meissner and Oschenfeld, and it is called Meissner effect. So the field inside a material can be written as B equal to mu zero into M plus H, where M is the magnetization and H, A is the applied magnetic field. So inside a superconductor, B equal to zero. So we can write mu zero into M plus H A, or M equal to minus H A, or M by H A equal to minus one. So this is susceptibility. Susceptibility is the ratio of magnetization to magnetic field intensity or magnetic intensity vector. So that ratio is minus one, means the material will behave like a perfect diamagnetic material. So according to Meissner effect, at superconducting state, the material will behave like a perfect diamagnetic material. So now we consider a superconducting ring. The superconducting ring is, superconducting ring, when it is kept in a magnetic field, so here temperature T is greater than TC, so the field lines can pass through the material. Now it is cooled below the transition temperature. When it is cooled, this superconducting ring is cooled below the transition temperature, then the field lines will be trapped inside the material, inside the superconducting ring. This trapped magnetic field inside the superconducting ring will be an integral multiple of a fundamental unit. That means the magnetic field trapped inside a superconducting ring is quantized. This is called flux quantization. When a solid superconductor is cooled, all the field lines will be expelled out of the superconducting material. But when a superconducting ring is cooled below the transition temperature, the field lines will be trapped. Field lines passing through the material body will be zero, but the field lines, There will be field lines inside the superconducting ring, and that will be quantized. It is called flux quantization. Now we will calculate the value of quantized field inside the superconducting ring. Particle probability amplitude, particle probability amplitude can be written as psi is equal to n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. Psi is particle probability amplitude, that can be written as n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. Now when we take the conjugate, psi star will be n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to minus I theta, and the psi star psi will be n raised to 1 by 2 into n raised to 1 by 2, it will be n, then e raised to I theta, e raised to minus I theta, that will be 1, which is equal to a constant. This value, it is the number of particles. It represents the number of particles. Here, particle means the electron pair. Each particle represents the Cooper particle, which is Cooper pairs, which consists of two electrons, one electron with up spin and another electron with down spin. So, they are electron pairs and the total spin is zero. So, they are considered as boson gas in superconducting state. Normal state, they are Fermi gas, and in superconducting state, they are boson gas. They are paired up. So, at absolute zero temperature, if you have total number of electrons, if you have capital N number of electrons in conduction band, then this particle will be, here the number of particles will be N by 2, since we are taking pair. That electron pair is taken as particle, and its density is given by psi star psi, and psi is given by N raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. This equation number 1, which represents the particle probability amplitude. Now we will calculate the particle flux. Particle flux. Particle flux means the number of particles, passing through unit area in unit time. That means particle flux means number of particles by area divided by time. Number of particles crossing unit area, normally unit area, passing through unit area in unit time, that is called a particle flux. That can be written as, particle flux can be written as, classically we can write it as N into V. N, here N represents, actually it is number density, not the number of particles, it is number density. So it will be number of particles per unit volume. So it will be number by volume into velocity is distance by time. Volume, we can write it as area into distance. So distance will get cancelled, then we will get area. Number by area into time. Number by area into time is called particle flux. So classically, we can write the particle flux as NV. In quantum mechanics, we can write the particle flux as, instead of writing NV, we will write the particle flux as psi star V psi. So the particle flux is given by psi star V psi, and we need to calculate the velocity. In this case, when we apply an electric field, we are studying the motion of particles under the effect of electric field or magnetic field. So in this case, it is velocity dependent potential. In the case of velocity dependent potential, we can write it as, we can write the momentum as mx dot plus qa. In all these cases, we are using SI unit. In SI system, it will be P equal to mx dot plus qa. In CGS system, it will be P equal to mx dot plus qa by c. We are using SI system, so it will be P equal to mx dot plus qa. So V is x dot. So x dot, from this we can calculate it as P minus qa divided by m. So it is 1 by m into P minus qa. So this momentum can be replaced by its operator. So we can replace it by momentum operator is P is minus ih bar del. It is minus ih bar del. So it will be 1 by m into minus ih bar del minus qa. So instead of v, we can write this value. Then psi is n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. Psi star is n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to minus I theta. So we will get the value of psi star v psi. Once we know psi star v psi, we can calculate the current density as. Current density. Current density, classical equation, we know the current density expression for current density as NVE or NVQ. Q is the charge of particle, N number density, then V is the velocity. instead of nv we are having psi star v psi. So when we multiply psi star v psi with the q charge of particle, we will get the current density. So in quantum mechanics we can write the current density j as q into nv. Nv we are having psi star v psi, so it will be j equal to q into psi star is n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta, then into 1 by m minus I h bar del minus QA operating on psi. Psi is n raised to 1 by 2. This is minus. Psi star is n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to minus I theta. So this is minus. Then here n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. Operating on this, we can write j equal to q n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to minus I theta into 1 by m, I am taking outside, by m into, here it is minus I h bar, del is space operator, so operating on this function, theta is taken as function of r, then this term will be minus I h bar del n raised to 1 by 2 operating del on e raised to I theta. Then it will be e raised to I theta into I into del theta. So this term operating on n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta, we will get it as minus I h bar n raised to 1 by 2, then e raised to I theta into I into del theta. Then minus QA n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. Taking n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta common, then we will get q n raised to 1 by 2 into n raised to 1 by 2, it is n by m, then e raised to minus I theta, then e raised to I theta, it will get cancelled. Then I square minus 1, this minus will become plus h bar, n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta is taken outside, then del theta minus q e, this term is taken outside. So the expression for current density we will get as j equal to q n by m into h bar del theta minus q a. From this equation we can also derive the London equation. For deriving London equation, take the curl of equation 1. When we take the curl of equation 1, it will be del cross j equal to q n by m h bar del cross del theta minus q del cross a. Del cross del theta, it is curl of gradient of a scalar function. It is identically 0. Del cross del theta, curl of gradient of a scalar function is equal to 0. So this term becomes 0. Then we can write del cross j equal to minus n q into q, q square by m del cross a. Del cross a is nothing but b. A is vector potential. So b is magnetic field intensity. B equal to del cross a. So we can write it as del cross j equal to minus n q square by m into b. This is London equation. So when we study London equation, we know that del cross j equal to minus n q square b by m. So using this theory we can also derive the London equation. Now we will calculate the flux trapped inside a superconducting material. So this is superconducting ring. flux is trapped field lines are trapped inside this material. I am taking a contour closed path shown in figure C is a contour. We are taking the closed path C and I am calculating the current density, the line integral of current density along the contour C. Well, inside the superconductor, according to Meissner's theory, both B and J are zero. So B equal to 0 and J equal to 0 when inside a superconducting material. So if along the contour J equal to 0, then integral J dot dl, which is line integral along the closed path, that should be equal to 0. So taking the curve, taking the line integral of equation 1, we are taking the line integral on both sides. So in left hand side, it will be integral J dot dl, which will be equal to 0. So left hand side, we can write it as 0. 0 equal to Qn by m, here first term is h bar into line integral of del theta dot dl, minus q into line integral of a dot dl, or can write 0 equal to first term is Qn by m h bar into integral del theta dot dl. Integral del theta dot dl is d theta. Integral d theta minus q. This line integral, using Stokes theorem, I am changing this line integral into surface integral. According to Stokes theorem, line integral of a dot dl, that can be written as surface integral del cross A dot ds. What is del cross A? Del cross A is B. So it can be written as surface integral of B dot ds. What is surface integral of B dot ds? It is magnetic flux. We can write it as phi. So integral A dot dl is a surface integral del cross A. Line integral of A is surface integral of del cross A, which is surface integral of magnetic field. Surface integral of magnetic field is magnetic flux. So second term we can write it as Q into magnetic flux phi. So this is equal to 0. On simplifying that, we will get Q phi equal to H bar into integral d theta. This equation we can rewrite it as, this equation can be written as Q phi equal to h bar into integral d theta. Integral d theta, we are taking over a complete path, and the phase change, I am taking initial phase as theta 1 and final phase after traveling a complete path, I am taking the final phase as theta 2. Theta 1 is initial phase and theta 2 is final phase. So it will be q phi equal to h bar into theta 2 minus theta 1. Theta 2 minus theta 1 represent the phase change occurred when we travel along the closed path, once around the closed path. This theta 2 minus theta 1, it is the phase difference, and theta 2 minus theta 1 should be equal to an integral multiple of 2 pi, where n is an integer. Because we know that the wave function psi r equal to n raised to 1 by 2 e raised to I theta. When you travel a complete distance, so psi r plus, if I travel a distance, take l as the total length of this path, then psi r plus l, that should be same as psi r. Wave function should repeat itself after traveling a complete path. We are returning back to the same point. Psi r plus l equal to psi r. This is possible only when e raised to I theta plus 2 pi. When I take e raised to I theta plus 2 pi, which is same as e raised to I theta and e raised to I 2 pi, e raised to I 2 pi is equal to 1. So when we have a phase change, which is an integral multiple of 2 pi n, integral multiple of 2 pi, then the e raised to I 2 pi n, that will be equal to 1. So this phase change, theta 2 minus theta 1, can be written as q phi equal to h bar into 2 pi n, or we can write the magnetic flux trapped inside this path as q phi equal to 2 pi h bar by q into n. That means we are getting the magnetic flux as, we are getting the magnetic flux as phi can be written as an integer multiple of a fundamental constant. That fundamental constant phi 0, its value is 2 pi h bar by q. It is flux quantum, it is called flux quantum, or it is called fluxoid. It's called fluxoid. Phi 0 equal to 2 pi h bar by q, or we can write it as h bar is h by 2 pi, so we can write it as h by q. Q, we know that we are taking the electron pair. Here the particle is electron pair. So it is having a charge, the magnitude of charge is 2e. So it can be written as phi equal to phi 0, the fluxoid equal to h by 2e. These all are in SI unit. We are taking the SI system. So it will be h by 2 pi. We know the value of Planck's constant as it is 6.625 into 10 to minus 34. And E value is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 10. If substituting there, we will get phi 0 approximately equal to 2.07 into 10 raised to minus 15 in SI unit, it is Tesla meter square. We can also represent this in CGS system. 1 Gauss equal to 10 raised to minus 4 Tesla, and 1 centimeter square equal to 10 raised to minus 4 meter square. So when we represent this in CGS system, we will be having phi 0 equal to 2.07 into 10 raised to minus 7, 8, then 15, minus 7 Gauss centimeter square. In CGS system, it will be 2.07 into 10 raised to minus 7 Gauss centimeter square. SI system, it will be 2.07 into 10 raised to minus 15 Tesla meter square. So that means the flux trapped by the superconducting ring is quantized. It is an integral multiple of a fundamental unit. So this flux is, flux trapped inside is quantized. Actually, this flux, the total flux trapped inside the material, then phi total can be written as sum of phi superconducting current plus phi external. It is the magnetic flux, external magnetic field flux, and this is phi sc is the magnetic flux due to superconducting current. Well, inside the superconductor, the current density J is 0, but this is due to the current passing through the surface of the superconductor. External magnetic flux is not quantized, but the total magnetic flux trapped inside is quantized. That means this is not quantized. This should be quantized. That means the superconducting current will flow in such a way that when we add this magnetic flux with the external magnetic field flux, the total flux passing through will be quantized. So that quantization condition is maintained by the magnetic flux produced by superconducting current, the current passing through the superconducting material along its surface, not interior, well inside the superconductor, J equal to 0. So this is about the flux quantization. Thank you.